Now, they're known for plain speaking in Lancashire, but what I want to know is why they've named a town after a sheep's rear end. Now, Kate, I was wondering if the name of the town has got anything to do with wool, as we are at a very old wool mill site here, aren't we?
There was a mill here back as far as 1628, so it's the oldest industrial site in Ramsbottom.
And it was a fulling mill, wasn't it? What does that mean?
Fulling was making woolen cloth thicker, and initially you would have a big tub of wool and then pour urine on it and stamp all over it and tread it down.
Urine?
That was the early process.
What is your theory about how Ramsbottom got its name?
One theory is that it's named after ramsons, which are wild garlic, and they grew down in the bottom of the valley, as they did in many river valleys. And that's certainly a possible theory, I think.
So, Ramsbottom did have a woolen industry, but the town only really took off when two Scottish brothers took to the high road and found themselves standing on that hill, looking down into the valley below, which may have been full of garlic. Oh.
The Grant brothers were among the first to see the potential for cotton milling in Ramsbottom with its plentiful supply of water. In the 19th century, this weaving shed would have been full of machinery and people.
Dirt, steam, it would have been dusty, noisy.
Yeah, cramped working
and
conditions.
Very cramped, highly dangerous when you've got children trying to work the machinery. It was a grim place. It must have been a horrible existence compared with our modern living.
Yeah, and I've heard that the Grants named the town after they saw two rams from the hill. Is that right?
Well, there's a few stories. That's a variation I haven't heard for some time, actually. It could be true. If you've a good imagination, you can believe anything, you know.
No definite answer there, then. But the mill owners, like the Grants, were all-powerful. They owned the houses where their workers lived and the shops where they bought their food.
This was a frontier town, and this produced something known as the truck system. The mill owners paid wages in kind, that is, in goods or rent for your house. But it was open to abuse because you got what was known as Tommy rot, which was in the Tommy shops. You got poor food, adulterated milk, sand in the sugar, all that sort of stuff, you know.
But in the 19th century, the workers were revolting, and Ramsbottom's doctor was right in the heart of the action.
And who was Peter McDowell?
Well, he was the only voice in the town that could speak up against the Grants because he was independent. And what he did in 1842 was go down to a parliamentary inquiry in London and effectively dish the dirt on the truck system.
McDowell supported Chartist demands for parliamentary reform, and that landed him in hot water.
He was in prison for a year at Chester Jail. He ended up marrying the jailer's daughter.
Oh, nice. But
he went on the run in 1842. He ended up going for a new life in Australia, and unfortunately he drowned on the way out there.
And what's your take on Ramsbottom? How do you think it got this strange name?
There's the garlic theory. There's a shipper bottom over there, which is the valley bottom where the sheep are. Ramsbottom suggests the valley bottom where the rams are. Or the bottom bit could actually be booths, meaning cottage or a hut, as in Bothy in Scotland. Three different theories, and it's up to you.
So, in Ramsbottom, it looks like you pays your money, you takes your choice. Ramsons or rams, wild garlic or sheep. Actually, that sounds a nice little combination. Little bit of mint sauce, lovely.